Graphic reads, Quiet Flight, with logos from the National Park Service and Powering Imagination. Video shows plane starting up. Speaker is John Penny, test pilot.
Well, today we were doing a flight test to do noise level signatures for the Park Service.
Noisy traditional airplane flies over. Speaker is Kurt Frista, National Park Service scientist.
We set up about a quarter of a mile off the runway at Centennial Airport, and we put out 3 sound level meters to measure the sound level of the aircraft.
Nearly silent electric aircraft flies over. Speaker is Eric Lindberg, Powering Imagination founder and CEO.
It's awesome to see this plane flying right overhead, 500 feet above. We're right underneath it, and we can barely hear it.
Another quiet flyover.
We were surprised, pleasantly surprised, by how dramatically quieter it could be.
Speaker is Kerry Beresford, chief engineer for Bi Aerospace.
We're standing in front of our technology demonstrator, an all-electric aircraft.
Speaker is Charlie Johnson, president of Aero Electric Aircraft Corporation.
And it has about up to an hour's worth of duration of flight. It is a proof of concept airplane for us. It's strictly battery powered by lithium-ion batteries.
The 2 biggest reasons that this has a distinct advantage over the primary trainers with internal combustion engines. Number 1, 0 emissions. It is environmentally friendly from that standpoint of view, but also there is a very low noise signature for the operation of these aircraft.
As an aviator, having flown my first electric aircraft a couple years ago, what really struck me was that absence of noise. That's amazing as a pilot, and I can't wait until I can fly one regularly.
Large numbers of people experience national parks from the air by taking commercial air tours. There are hundreds of thousands of flights over parks each year. We have an interesting problem in that experience is compelling enough that people are willing to pay hefty sums of money to fly an aircraft over parks. We also have a lot big noise problem on the ground.
Noisy traditional airplane flies over.
We need to figure out how to make it quiet, not only for humans, but for noise-sensitive environments like the national parks.
Birdsong in quiet woods.
We're very interested in quiet aircraft technology because it has the potential to remove this inherent conflict between people who would like to flight see from the air and the millions of visitors on the ground who don't want their soundscapes degraded by aircraft noise.
We're trying to preserve our natural resources. We're trying to be environmentally friendly. One of the reasons we enjoyed working with the Park Service today is we want to keep the peace and tranquility that we have in our country.
Yosemite National Park.
What we're seeing is that promise, and the promise is not only quiet aircraft, but clean aircraft.
I really don't think that there's a limit to what electric flight can do for us. As the motor and battery technologies evolve, we will very quickly move into 4, 6, and potentially 8, 10, and 12 place aircraft.
I think this technology provides an opportunity to transcend the current challenge that the Park Service faces in trying to reduce noise levels on the ground while not severely impacting the small business opportunities and the flight seeing opportunities in the air.
With an airplane like this that makes very, very little noise, as you were able to witness today out there, the potential for tourism over a national park area in an electric powered airplane, I think would allow more flexibility for the person providing that product for the customer.
And make no mistake about it, electric propulsion is really the way of the future.
Nearly silent electric aircraft flies past. Graphics on screen read, Powering Imagination, National Park Service. Special thanks to Centennial Airport, Powering Imagination, Bi Aerospace, PC Aero, and the Aero Electric Aircraft Corporation. Graphic reads, Just arrived, Sunflyer prototype all-electric trainer.